Welcome back to Calculus 3. And in this part, we will continue to study line integrals. A line integral could be defined for a function of two variables, like here, function of two variables, f dot dr. It should be calculated in the fashion of line integral of pdx qdy. And then we did one example in the previous lecture. Okay, in the three-dimensional case, f dot dr, it is a line integral from all three parts, pdx, qdy, r, dc. So this part, I just want to explain quickly, how do we calculate a line integral in the three-dimensional case? Evaluate a line integral in the form of pdx, qdy, and r, dc. The line integral we are considering here, it is zdx, xdy, ydc. And also we do know the curve, it has the parametric equation form, t squared, or the vector equation form, t squared, square root of t, t. And the t is running from 1 to 4. And look at the equation of the curve very carefully. This part simply means x is t squared, y is square root of t, z is t. So accordingly, you can calculate dx, dy, dc, and they will be used in the calculation of pdx, qdy, rdc. Okay. So now moving into the calculation part, we are having zdx. Z, as I just explained, it's t. Dx, it's 2x dt, right? So it is this should be 2t dt, because x is t squared. Certainly dx is 2t dt. So z, it is replaced with t, as we observed from the vector equation of the curve. Then dx, it is replaced with 2t dt. Then the second part, x dy. X is t squared. Dy, it is from here. Okay, so the entire thing intended to be integral dt, right? And then similarly for y dc, y, it is t to the 1/2 for square root of t. Dc, it is dt, so dt. So look closely to this moment, this line integral, indeed it is turning to be an integral in terms of t only. And furthermore, each part has dt, so we can take out the dt. Okay, so indeed, this is just a single integral in terms of t only. And certainly, it still will take a little time to figure out all the details. Hopefully, you can track, you can follow through those things line by line. Everything about t, 2t squared, t squared times t to the negative 1/2, that's t to the 3/2. That 1/2 as a coefficient, it still stays. Then t to the 1/2. Then calculate the antiderivative of each term. And then I got the antiderivative. Then plug in numbers. The upper bound for t is 4. The lower bound is 1. Then do a subtraction. This is example 6.20. Okay, I did take the number from the textbook directly. It turns out to be 793/15. This is a line integral. So in summary, this section 6.2, it is a discussion of line integrals. One, physics explanation of line integral, it can be considered as the work done by a force. For moving object along a curve, and it is denoted as the line integral of f dot dr. And then f dot dr, it should be considered in two cases. For the two-dimensional case, a line integral, really, it is in the fashion of pdx qdy. In the three-dimensional case, the line integral, it is in the fashion of pdx, qdy, and rdc. And then you may wonder, again, you cannot evaluate the integral in terms of x only, y only separated, because x, y, they are dependent, they are related. Okay, they are intertwined together. You cannot treat those two parts separated. And the same for the triple line integral in the three-dimensional case, you cannot separate pdx, qdy, rdz. The trick is you want to understand x, y, z. Usually they are given by the vector equation of the curve. So you can take out x, y, z. Each it is a variable of time t. So eventually the line integral, it turns out to be integral over a single variable of time t. And we did two examples. Hey, I want to thank you for watching. At the moment, this is really all about line integrals.